Yeah, good morning, children. Due to this coronavirus, as all of us are sitting at our home and our school, and the teachers trying their level best to teach you through online. And I am your accounts and commerce teacher. Today I explain the rules applicable in the absence of partnership deed. So when there is no deed between the partners, so provisions applied as per Indian Partnership Act 1932 are as follows. So interest on capital shall not be allowed. That means no partners is entitled to receive any interest on capital. Next, interest on drawings shall not be charged. Means the firm is also not charged the drawing interest on drawings. Means the partners are not liable to pay any interest on drawings. Next, no partner is entitled to any salary. Now the questions arise, if any partners give the extra time to the firm, then whether he is eligible to receive any salary? The answer is no. Why? Because in the absence of partnership deed, no partner is entitled to any salary. Next, no partner is entitled to any commission. Likewise, it's this, the partners are not entitled to receive any sorts of commission. Clear? Next, profit or loss should be shared equally. So if there is no deed between the partner, then the profit should be shared equally irrespective of the investment. I take one example. Suppose A, B, C are partner in a firm. A invest 10 lakhs, B invest 9 lakhs and C invest 1 lakh. Now, if A and B decided to share the profits in their capital ratio, that means 10:9:1. Is this possible? The answer is no. The profit, whatever may be, that should be shared between A and B, A, B and C in their profit sharing ratio. And last point, not the least, if any partners provide any loan to the firm, then that partners will receive interest at the rate of 6% per annum. So in a question, if you see that the rate of interest on partners loan is not given, then you have to calculate the interest at the rate of 6% per annum. The next video I will send you for calculation of interest on capital. Hello children, welcome back again. Now I am discussing how to calculate the interest on capital under different situations. So there are three types of capital. As you see, I have already explained it in my notes. First one is opening capital, then additional capital, and finally one capital is there, that is closing capital. Now, what is the opening capital? The initial investment that is made by the partner in the business at the time of starting the business, that is called opening capital. Now, how will you calculate interest on opening capital? Obviously, the interest on this capital will be calculated for full year, that is 12 months. Next, how will you calculate interest on additional capital? Now, first of all, what is additional capital? The capital which is introduced by the partners further in the business during the financial year, that is called additional capital. Now, see, if the date of investment of capital, this type of capital is given, then from the date of that investment to the closing date, you will calculate the interest. But if the date of investment of such additional capital is not given, then you calculate for 6 months. The complete this, you can understand by seeing this example. I have given one example, note it. See, A, B, C are partners. They invest rupees 1 lakh, rupees 50,000. And 40,000 respectively, interest on capital at the rate of 12% per annum. Now, B further invest 20,000 on 1st October 2009. Note it, the date of the further capital investment is given, 1st October 2019. And C further invest rupees 10,000. So, the date of C's further investment is not given. Now, calculate interest on capital of the partners. Assume that book closure of accounts is the calendar year. Calendar year means 31st December. Now, how will you solve this problem? So, obviously, you see 1,50,000, 40,000. These are the opening capital of A, B and C. So, you will calculate the interest for 12 months as I have shown it here. You see, 1 lakh into 12 by 100, then B, 50,000 into 12 by 100 and C, 40,000 into 12 by 100. Now, additional capital which is introduced by B on 1st October 2019. So, from 1st October 2019 to 31st December 2019, it is October, November, December, 3 months. So, you will have to calculate the interest on 20,000 for 3 months. That here, I have shown it here, you see. And I have written date of further investment given, this portion. So, summation of these two will be the interest of B, that is 6,600. Likewise, this C, C's additional investment is 10,000, but the date of investment is not given. So, you will have to calculate the interest on 10,000 for 6 months. See, it is, I have shown it here. 10,000 into 1200 into 6 by 12. So, I have written also, date of further investment is not given. Now, summation of these two will be the interest of C. I hope that you can understand. Hello children, welcome back again. The second part for calculation of interest on capital. In the previous problem, you have seen that there is no drawings. Now, if there is the drawings made by the partners as well as additional capital introduced by the partners, then how will you calculate the interest on capital? In the previous example, suppose A draws 1st August 2019 rupees 5,000, B 1st March 2019 7,000 and C draws 1st November 2019 6,000. Then how will you calculate the interest? Now, here, see, in this page, I have written, as you see in the problem that A invest, this is the case of A. A invests rupees 1 lakh on 1st January 2019 and he draws 5,000 on 1st August 2019. So, rupees 1 lakh is invested from 1st January 2019 to 1st August 2019. That is for 7 months. So, you will have to calculate interest for 7 months only. Here you see, interest on 1 lakh, I have calculated for 7 months. Clear? Now, after the drawings of 5,000, the investment reduced to 95. How 95? 1 lakh initial investment is there and 5,000 drawings made by A. So, now the investment is remains 95,000. And it will continue from 1st August to 31st December. That is for 5 months. So, you will have to calculate interest on this remaining amount, that is 95,000, for 5 months only. Here you see the calculation. 95,000 into 12 by 100 into 5 by 12. The interest comes rupees 11,750. Now, B's case. B invest 50,000 on 1st January, then further investment made by him rupees 20,000 as on 1st October 2019. And in between this, he draws 7,000 on 1st March 2019. So, what actually happened? As on 1st March 2019, he draws 7,000 from his initial investment. So 50,000 remains for 2 months in the business. So, you will calculate the interest on 50,000 for 2 months. You see, then the investment reduced to 43,000, 7,000 drawings made by him, and it is remains in the business for 10 months. From 1/3/2019 to 31st December 2019. So you calculate the interest for 10 months. And the further investment made by him, that is on 1st October. So separately you calculate the interest on 20,000 for 3 months. The summation of all these three is 5,900. Clear? Likewise, this C is initial investment 40,000. And C draws on 1st November. So from 1st January to 31st October, that means 10 months his investment is there. 40,000 into 12/100 into 10/100. Then it is reduced to 34,000. 34,000 for 2 months, November and December. 34,000 into 12/100 into 2/12. And his initial investment 10,000. Clear? That is on 1st July. So you have to calculate the interest for 6 months. So summation of these three will come rupees 5,240. So diagram is there. If you are able to understand, then okay. Otherwise, it is not required because the video will be very lengthy if I will explain.